If you want to know how Donald Trump's company's stock is doing, all you need to know is that he went on Truth Social earlier today begging his followers to invest in it. He posted this: "I am so proud of Truth Social because I believe it represents the Make America Great Again movement, and it shows the capital S spirit and capital L love of our country. If people who believe in putting America first and want to make America great again support Truth, we will be your voice like never before. And a real voice is what our country needs, because we are in decline and must bring America to greatness." Well, I don't believe that America is necessarily in decline, but his stock definitely is, because it is dropping fast. On March 26, following its quite successful IPO, it was trading for nearly $75 a share. And you can see pretty much where things went from there. And I'm not a savvy investor or anything, I don't know if you are, but I don't think that's what you want your stock to look like about a month out. Now, I think it might have rallied very slightly near the end of the day. It might be up to like $33, but that's
32.
Okay, between $32 and $33, but that's still not good. At least as of when CNBC measured it, it had dropped by more than 47% month to date, wiping out literally billions of dollars. And since Donald Trump owns 60% of the shares, 60% of the billions of dollars that went, that got Thanosed, was his. It was his, it's not his anymore. Because he couldn't sell it, he has to wait 6 months. Now, I want to remind all of you sort of why perhaps it's trending in this direction. Trump Media last year had revenue of just $4.1 million, which is not bad for an ice cream shop, but not good for an international social media network or platform. It reported a loss of $58 million. And honestly, like, just invest in me. I can lose $40 or $50 million and I could do it in style. And yet they're throwing all the money at him. In any event, this isn't looking good for him. He was really banking on this eventually bailing him out. That this stock, which is objectively worth absolutely nothing, would suddenly be worth billions of dollars. He'll be able to trade the stock away to some rube and suddenly he'll have money once again. But the issue is that if things continue to trend in the direction they're looking right now, in 6 months, I mean, people will be using the stock as like party favors or confetti. It's not going to be worth anything. What do you think?
Yeah, I can explain all this.
Pausing here to deliver some honest truth, as we do in our news coverage as well. TYT is facing challenges, guys, as the entire industry is. You know who could make the difference? You. If you hit the join button below, it's going to make all the difference and keep us in business. We appreciate you. Thank you.
First of all, let me just tell you, I'm so mad. Because I'm mad that I missed out on the opportunity to short the stock. It was very hard to do it right in the beginning, and then I got distracted. But I could have told you, and in fact, I did tell you on the air that this has no chance of success. When it was a 75, you should have shorted it. Okay, so you all should have done it. And don't worry, a lot of people did. Shorting it means betting against the stock so you make money when it goes down. Because this thing's headed to, very likely, in my opinion, now take this for what it's worth, it'll go down to zero is my guess. So let me explain why. Why is it worth billions now, but eventually might be worth zero? Because when you go into the stock market, there's supposed to be the wisdom of the masses, and the prices fluctuate based on what people are willing to pay, right? And eventually the stock market, with all of its massive flaws, does get to a valuation over the long term that is relatively correct, okay? But that's over the long term and for most stocks. The bet here is that Trump fans will be completely irrational and they will give this stock a price it doesn't deserve at all. And does it deserve $32 that it closed at today? Did it deserve the $79 that it peaked at? It's laughable, guys. It's laughable. So based on the numbers that they put out there, Young Turks would then be worth at least $32 billion.
Nice.
Ooh, I didn't know we were that rich. Okay,
It's comical, comical. So the whole thing is a Ponzi scheme. And the reason why Trump is going out there and making a plea, they're like, hey, if you love this country, make sure that you're still buying the Truth Social stock, is because he's gotta make it to 6 months. That's when he can start dumping it. So if it's not worth zero by then, he's gonna make money anyway, right? And it's when it eventually goes to zero, everyone who bought it is gonna get stiff. Guys, it's not just that they lost $58 million last year. They only made $4 million in revenue.
And okay, then you ask them, what's your plan to catch up? Some stocks catch up, you know, they used to put on a big investment, and like Amazon did, right? Obviously a very different business, etc. And yes, they had way more. Amazon had always had like literally thousands of times this revenue by the time they went to public, etc. But even so, they were losing money. You were like, oh, can they turn it around? No, their idea was to gain market share and then later become profitable, which they did spectacularly so, right? Could this do the same thing? No, it cannot. Because when you ask them, what's your plan to make money later? They're like, well, Trump is magic. Trump is magic, so we're magically gonna make money. That's not a thing. You have to give us a business plan. And now it's a publicly traded company. You have to show people, here's the amount of revenue we can make. Here's how we would make it. That's what a public company is supposed to do. This thing's a joke. Everybody in Wall Street is thinking, come on in, suckers, come on in, because we're all gonna short it. That's why it was so hard to get in on the short. And we're all gonna make a ton of money taking money from these poor saps that are MAGA. Yeah. That's just reality, and you're seeing it on the stock market. That's as real as it gets.
A Trump business or a Trump venture performing true to form. I mean, if Trump is part of it, this is what's gonna happen. So none of us should be surprised. I mean, I'm surprised anybody's surprised.
Yeah, it makes Trump's stakes look like a good business, because at least there were stakes.
Look, guys, I give two things to back up what Nina's saying as quickly as I can. One, he bought this airline company. First of all, literally everything he's bought has gone bankrupt, okay? Outside of the couple of properties he has left, like the golf properties in Mar-a-Lago, right? So he bankrupted six major businesses. One of them was an airline company. He buys it, and it's like a commuter airline. People will actually going from New York to Boston, New York to DC, I think, et cetera. And they have to keep costs low. And he's like, no, I want our toilets to be golden. So he spent a ton of money on the airline and it went bankrupt. Okay, in Atlantic City, he started three casinos all at the same time. Everybody's like, they're gonna cannibalize one another. It's like there's not enough customers in Atlantic City. He's like, no, I wanna see my name in lights in three different places. Trump, Trump, Trump. All of them went bankrupt. This guy's a moron of the highest order. The only reason why people think he's a good businessman is because of Jeff Zucker, who put him on The Apprentice and pretended that he was a successful businessman. When Zucker knew for a fact that he was a loser, one of the biggest failures in American business history. He's already lost $400 million twice. Okay, so true social. Hey, listen, if you don't believe me and you're a right winger, oh yeah, you young Turks, you guys are biased, man. It's not gonna work out. Go buy a stock. Go buy a stock and I'll go short it. And then we'll see who's right. Okay?
Speaking of which, very good evidence of him being a bad businessman. And I have no evidence of this. I don't know how one would acquire evidence of this, but is there any chance? Because you know, he needs money. He's gotta wait 6 months. Is there any chance that he shorted it? Is there any way that we would be able to find out if he or members of his family shorted it?
How would we ever know? Wait. John's onto something really good, because Trump's not smart enough to short his own stock. Okay, and then there could be issues, etc. And he really desperately wants to take money out of that thing. He's got to keep it afloat for 6 months until contractually he can start to take money out. But could Jared Kushner have shorted the stock? I don't know. That would be an interesting investigation.
Interesting.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.